Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to do a cyclist guide to the Cannondale SmartSense system. Cannondale's SmartSense system is an innovative and controversial approach to combining headlights, taillights, and radars into a single seamless package. Rather than recharging three separate batteries and then controlling them individually, the SmartSense system features integrated cable routing with a central SmartSense battery on the downtube of Cannondale's bikes. This is currently only available in the Synapse and Topstone bikes, but we wouldn't be surprised if Cannondale extends it to more models in the near future. As far as specs, the system requires a SmartSense compatible bike, which has the internal cable routing provisions for the system. You have a 2,665 milliamp core battery, which controls all the radar and lights. You have a Garmin Varia rear radar, as well as a Lazine developed headlight and taillight. The headlight is a 350 lumen Foresight E350, and the taillight is the Hindsight Array E85. In German countries, there's an STVZO variation of these as well. The bikes are currently available as the RLE or the LE variations, or just an L. What you see here in the background is the Cannondale Synapse 2 RLE, which has the radar, the lights, and also the electronic shifting, which makes it the RLE. But again, you can purchase a bike with just the lights or the lights and the radar, and then Cannondale does offer each of the components separately as well, so you can purchase the lights or you can purchase a radar in the cable routing system. Now let's take a look at the individual components of the SmartSense system. Here we have the headlight. It is fairly large with a trapezoidal shape and a reflector style beam. So you can have an LED on top and a big reflector to focus the light on the ground. So you don't have any glare, which is really great, and 350 lumens of output. It also is GoPro mounted to the bottom of the out front mount and powered directly with the cable that runs from the down tube into the back. It also has an output port that lets you connect the Varia display. So pretty cool setup, and although it is a little bit chunky, it is effective on the road, and again, with the GoPro mounting, it's easy to move this position to another mount. Here we have the Varia display unit, and this displays an array of LEDs, which will actually move toward you as you have cars, and you have a colored indicator on the bottom, so green is all clear, and then go red if there's cars. It also has audible beeps to let you know when there's vehicles approaching, and then again when it's all clear. The central battery is right on the down tube with this built-in cradle. USB Type-C charging port on the top will let you actually charge other devices or recharge the battery. Nice toggle switch to install it, and you can see all the cables are internally routed. You don't have any cables to worry about here. You can also put this on a bottle mount, which they offer separately, and you can see it just locks into place with a 4 LED indicator to tell you the battery status. On the rear, you have the Varia radar, as well as the E85 array taillight. So you see the Hindsight light wraps right around the Garmin Varia radar. So pretty slick setup, and it's saddle rail mounted. You can see you can tilt the angle really easily, and it tucks underneath the saddle. If you want to put a saddle bag, you need to get a GoPro extender to push this out a little bit to let you get these straps on, which are not included from the factory. Now let's take a look at the output modes. There are only four modes to choose from. You have high vis, which is 14 hours and grade 4 daytime riding. You have twilight, which is more constant for nighttime riding with 4-hour runtime. Then you have power save mode, which gives you up to 20 hours and a little bit lower brightness. And then finally pulsing, which is also 4 hours and pulses the front and rear. Now what's great about this system is that everything communicates with each other. So the ambient light sensor, the rear radar, all communicate with the light, so they automatically adjust. So you'll see here the taillight and the headlight will actually automatically react when there's a car approaching and go into a more reactive mode to ensure that you're visible on the road. When you're riding in low light conditions, like going through a dark tunnel, automatically switch to the twilight mode to give you more light so you actually see in front of you. So it's really nice. You don't have to press any buttons. Automatically reacts to different times of day and if there's vehicles around you. Even though the taillight's not the best we've seen, you can see with the multiple LEDs, the different flashing patterns, it is visible on the road and it's tucked right underneath the saddle for a really clean look. And there you just saw the little panic mode when there's a car visible. You also have a braking feature, so it'll automatically switch when you're braking, again, to give you more visibility. It's a really nice system, and again, with the speed sensor on the front wheel, it automatically turns on and then turns off, so you never have to press the buttons. You can also use the app to customize the behavior and switch every single mode to get a really personalized experience. Now let's take a look at the Cannondale app. It's a really well-made app that lets you control the bike and also has a lot of riding functions built in. So you can see here, we have it on our Synapse Carbon 2 RLE, so it gives you full specs of the bike. You can set up service reminders as you accumulate mileage. I'll actually track that, and then you can remember to do a tune-up or swap the chain. You also have a full part list for your specific bike. So this is all the stock settings, and then you can edit them as you swap out components and you have a record of it. So pretty nicely set up, and Cannondale's obviously put the time and effort into it to really make it intuitive. You can also fully control the SmartSense system, which is really nice. So you have a big power button there, shows you the status, shows you the battery output in a percentage. And then you can change some of the default behavior. You can see here by default, everything is mostly on, so it's a very intuitive setup. You have auto eco mode, so once the battery goes low, it will switch into eco mode. Auto awake, which means it automatically turns on once you start moving the wheel, and automatically puts it asleep as well, and that's on by default. You can also change all the light modes, so you can edit these. There's a little edit button on the far right, so you can change them to exactly what you want, and you have a nice animation on top that shows you what that mode means. Here you have some additional features, such as the brake alert, the radar alert, and you can turn them on and off as needed. Again, by default, everything is on, and I would leave it on unless it's something you really don't want. If you want to extend the battery life, you can turn off the brake alert feature, though, or the react to radar option, which would extend the light output as you get more consistent output. But otherwise, really well set up, and you can see all the descriptions for what each one means. It's listed right below it, so there's no ambiguity. You can also upgrade the firmware as needed. Auto proximity flash is off by default, and that just flashes the light when you approach with the cell phone. It also has a full ride mode option, so you can do a bunch of ride displays here. And again, from this, you can control the lights directly, so you can press the button and change it mid-ride, and it will also show the radar output and give you secondary audible notifications. It's a pretty cool feature and replaces the need for a GPS computer if you're doing more urban riding or just don't want to have a dedicated GPS. Now let's go over the pros and cons for the Cannondale SmartSense system. What we like about it is that you have a sharp beam cutoff. So the headlight has a reflector style lens that really focuses all the light on the ground and eliminates any glare for oncoming traffic, which is perfect for riding on shared trails. You also have a really seamless experience as the lights automatically turn on and then off as they use the speed sensor on the front wheel to know when you start moving. And then when you stop moving for an extended period of time, it automatically shuts off. So you really don't have to press any buttons at all. You also don't have to worry about multiple batteries as you have that single core battery on the downtube. So you can simply check the battery status using the app or click in the power button with the multi-LED display. The main negatives with the system is the fact that it's proprietary, so you can't swap in your own headlights and taillights as they have a special connector. And there's also no available options, so you can't upgrade the lights, use more compact ones or higher output, and there are no battery options. We really would have liked to see a larger battery. We're doing long rides, so with the current one, we only get about 10 hours, but it'd be great to see one that's double the size. Also, it requires a GoPro extender if you want to use a saddlebag, as the radar and rear taillight are saddle rail mounted, so it's very hard to get saddlebag on there, so you definitely need that extender. That said, we still think the system's really well designed. It's a great way to get all your light and radar with the bike in one single shot. You don't have to worry about buying multiple items. Everything's seamlessly attached, and you don't even have to press any buttons. We just wish Cannondale would add more upgradability to really help justify the cost and give you more options, so bigger batteries, higher output lights, or even more compact lights to justify daytime riding versus a nighttime rider. Thanks for watching the Cyclist Guide. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclist. This is The Sweet Cyclist, reminding you to enjoy the ride.